cooking with gas.
Cooking with gas.
We all cook better when we're cooking with gas.
Gas is so hot, it's not on when it's off. It's the only way to cook. That's what I was taught.
Who says I don't like music? So obviously gas is very, very cool. I mean, not cool, it's hot, but it's cool that it's hot. Anyway, that was a promotional video for cooking with gas stoves from, I hope, a long time ago. The longer ago, the more acceptable it becomes. But despite propaganda like that from the companies making money off of having you use gas for your cooking, it turns out it actually has some negative effects. So the federal government is now looking into whether we need to phase out the technology. And I use that language very intentionally to try to avoid conservatives pretending that what's being called for is people showing up with your at your house and taking your stove away. No one is calling for that, and it's not going to happen. Do we understand that? Okay, maybe we can proceed. Anyway, for years, scientists and health advocates have been trying to bring attention to what they consider a sort of hidden source of air pollution inside at least 40 million homes in the US, because cooking with gas releases gas into the home, and that stuff, I almost swore, isn't consequence free. It jumpstarts childhood asthma, increases the risk of respiratory problems, and of course is gas that goes into the atmosphere, which is bad for it in terms of climate change. And in response to that, now something is finally beginning to be done. On Monday, Richard Trumka Jr., one of the four commissioners of the US Consumer Product Safety Commission, said in an interview that the agency was considering a ban on gas stoves, or at least standards around the amount of toxic fumes such stoves can spew into Americans' kitchens. So either phasing out the technology in new construction, or making it so that the stoves have to be more efficient and not waste so much gas just putting it out into the homes. He said this is a hidden hazard. Any option is on the table. Products that can't be made safe can be banned. Although again, it is not going to be taken out of your home. He responded to a tweet from Gary Palmer saying, over 40 million American households use gas stoves. This type of power should never have been given to unelected bureaucrats, and it's time for it to end, by saying, to be clear, CPSC isn't coming for anyone's gas stoves. Regulations apply to new products. For Americans who choose to switch from gas to electric, there is support available, including in the Inflation Reduction Act, an $840 rebate, which can help to defray the cost of that transition. So again, this would be for new construction. They're not gonna be carting away your stoves, you morons. Although, in their defense, I have also read, and AOC pointed this out on Twitter, that the natural gas has also been linked to cognitive problems. So maybe this is just proving the point in their response to this discussion. But JR, what do you think?
The extreme emotional nature of legislators and people who want to push political agendas like this is it's blaring, but I don't know how we don't see it yet. Everything has to be, they're coming for you, they're coming for you, they're coming for you. It's technological advances. Anything that's progression or advancement, for some reason, has to be, they're coming to F and kill you. They want to take your stove out of your house because we've paid people to come and find your stove and take it out of your house. It's this cartoonish scenarios that they're putting together. It's why we have QAnon and stuff, and they're taken seriously because it's only one step further than the things elected officials say. It's insane. So, by the way, you can continue trying to use your gas stoves, but if technological advancements change these things, you might not have much of a reason to use it anymore. No, they're not gonna come take it and smash it across your two-year-old's head because they're out to get you. It's weird, yeah, bro. If you've got your iPod Nano still, you can still try to use it.
But you're probably not I do have one.
Can you use it?
I think I've charged it from time to time. I don't actually use it, but yeah.
Charged it. Bro, it's not useful anymore. You can have it when you see it laying around and be like, oh, I remember that from 2012 or something like that. You can have it, but it may not really work for your life anymore because the world has moved on. These people won't be stuck in this old age. It's craziness.
Exactly. Yeah. I guess pointing out that burning methane and other chemicals releases nitrogen dioxide, carbon monoxide, formaldehyde. It gets into your lungs, significantly raises the chance of your child having asthma. Is that what about save the children? You didn't really mean it. You didn't actually mean. Like, I get it. You've got a gas stove, and you have been trained by Fox News to believe that literally anything changing ever is Hitler stuff. But like, you know, we used to just cook in campfires. We moved on from that. sometimes progress is a good thing, and again, you're not being forced to do it. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.